it's Nimi here. Thanks for watching my new video. This title is quite self-explanatory. It's very much about positive thinking and the techniques I kind of used over the last couple of years to change my negative into positive. To give you a bit of a background, for as long as I can remember, I feel like I was such a negative thinker. And looking back on it now, you know, you're kind of like, wow, I was so bad. Only the last couple of years I've transformed my negative thinking into positive thinking, and still, like, the job is not finished because it takes a lot of time. It's very much a choice. I had that choice to wake up every morning and decide if I wanted to be a positive thinker or a negative thinker, and I used to choose the negative almost every time. It got really bad and dark at one point where I used to get really bad anxiety, and it really wasn't very nice, but the last couple of years I've made that conscious decision and that choice to become a positive thinker. One technique that I started off with from day one, from when I decided to do this, I guess, was writing notes to myself. So every morning I would read them, and every night before I go to bed, I would read them. And it would literally be like about 4 to 5 things that I like about myself. It could be things like from a physical appearance thing, like I like my hair, or I like my eyes, or to something like a characteristic trait, like I like that I'm tidy, or, you know, little things like that. And at first it was really, really hard for me to even think of 5 things. Believe it or not, if it's the first thing that you read in the morning, your day is gonna go so differently. My friend who was going through a bit of a hard time, I told her to try this technique and she said it worked wonders. So if you try it, let me know how it goes. Visual. So everything's so visual for me when it comes to negative and positive thinking. So if someone or something throws negativity my way, literally I envision it as an actual object that they're throwing my way. And I envision myself catching it. And when I catch it, I literally throw it back. I mean, I don't physically like do the action when they're like being mean to me, but if they say something, I literally just like, I'm receiving it, but I'm heading it right back your way. You're not throwing it back at the person in the sense that you mean harm to them, you're throwing it away from you. You're literally physically taking that situation away from you, and this technique has helped me so much. Now, it's so important to surround yourself with positive people. Like, I can't even explain to you how this has changed my life. There has been people in my life that just drained me, that just brought out the worst in me, that kind of just made me into a person that I really didn't want to be. Ever since they have exited my life, it's just changed my life completely. I now surround myself with friends and family who are just such great influence on me. They make me laugh, they make me crack jokes, they crack jokes. Like, it's just so great to be surrounded by good energy. I look back now and I'm like, how was that person even in my life for that long? Because they really didn't deserve to be. And that's the place that you need to get to. And that's gonna happen if you surround yourself with good people. Believe. Now, it's so important for you to believe positive. Like, when I say believe positive, grammatically it's incorrect, but meaning like convince yourself of the positivity within you and around you. This can go from anything, from like your career to relationships to life goals to ambitions, anything in life. Whether it be like making a bed, believe that you make the bed really well and it can happen. Negativity is there to cloud your judgment. It's gonna be there. It's like your worst enemy, and it's like your belief is here and the negativity is here and they're fighting each other. And it's so important that you kind of overcome that and you know that your belief is stronger than anything. Talk. Now, I'm so lucky that I now have that kind of personality where I can talk about my feelings and express myself really well about anything that's stressing me out or bugging me or getting me down. But it's so important, again, this leads on to the whole surround yourself with good people, because I have my mum, dad and my sister who I can 100% rely on if I have anything I want to talk about. And I know they won't judge me for it. So you can talk to people who you think won't judge you for anything that you say. They won't make you feel like a bad person. Just get it all out. It makes such a difference. If you're not the kind of personality to want to talk to anyone, then you can definitely use other techniques like writing things down in a diary. I used to type things out on my Mac and then literally like throw it into the recycle bin after. Like, I wouldn't read it over. I just get it all out and then I chuck it away because it was done. Breathing exercises. Now, these are so important and have transformed my life for the last 2 months. I started in January in the new year as a New Year's resolution. And I use an app actually, which I can tell you about. There's so many apps out there and they're mostly meditation apps. The reason I'm not saying meditation is because I'm no pro at meditation and I really don't know the ins and outs of it. So I call it breathing exercises. Here you go. The app is called Headspace and the icon looks like that. I hope you can see it. It's helped me so much because it's got really great voices on it as well, that kind of when you're about to go to bed, the kind of voices that you want to listen to, not like a rough growly voice. It does exactly what the app's called. It gives you headspace. It allows you to just forget everything, forget your troubles, forget any negative thoughts, and kind of just relax and get some inner peace. It's so important to do this first thing in the morning and last thing at night. It helps you sleep so much better. I knock out within like 10 minutes. One last thing with the breathing exercises is, again, the visual thing comes into it. I literally imagine myself breathing in the positive and breathing out the negative. And just doing that just kind of helps me so much. Mind training is something that does not happen overnight. It's a process and by no means am I a pro. I'm like 2 months in, but it's already transformed my life so much. By mind training, I mean like training your mind to understand the triggers of things that make you upset or make you negative or make you anxious or worried. Now I know when I'm about to be negative and now I can stop myself because my mind has trained itself to understand when I'm about to think something negatively. It's amazing what your mind can do. You're actually a genius, you just don't know it yet. Eat the right things, it's so important. And I say this for someone who used to literally fill their body with rubbish and it kind of brought out rubbish mind thoughts. Like, if you eat clean and neat and healthy, then you're just gonna be so much cleaner in your mind. Exercise is just like the whole food thing. Working out in the morning or taking Milo for a walk is so important and pivotal to make my day better. You just gotta think about it, like the more physical activity you get, the more positive energy within yourself and the more, I guess, scientifically, oxygen reaching your brain to help you think clearer. Lastly, the first thing that I think about when I think about negative thoughts is my career. Like, all of these things that I should be thinking about is, oh, all the things that I have achieved. And I don't think about that. I think about all the negatives that I haven't achieved. It's crazy how the mind works, because you kind of like are completely ignoring the fact that you've achieved so much already and are so set on focusing on the negatives. Reading really helped me with this. It's changed my life. And there are certain books that kind of, I have to say, I could recommend to you all to kind of help change your life. And the first one is by Jill Hassan. It's called A Brilliant Emotional Intelligence, and it says, harness the power of emotions to succeed in all areas of your life. And this really helped with controlling my emotions. It helps you drive your emotions and take them away from the negative sides that you're wasting your emotions on and directing them towards the positive. I'll put the link below if this is something that you're interested in purchasing. The second one is women who worry too much. Now, I'm sorry, guys, men, boys, for cancelling you out of this, but if you do have, like, I don't know, a girlfriend or a partner or a friend who does kind of suffer from negative thinking or anxiety or stress or worrying, then this might help them. It says how to stop worry and anxiety from ruining relationships, work, and fun. And truly, this is exactly what it did. It kind of helps you to harness your worrying in and not, and just think that, what am I worrying about? Like, after I read this book, I was literally like, what am I stressing about? It makes you just think like, oh my God, I was crazy. Like, I need to calm down, you know? If you're like me and suffer a lot from anxiety, it kind of helps you to learn your triggers. It helps you to kind of face your fears so much. And it's great because it has loads of great content without, which asks you questions and that you could answer yourself. So this one's really good. Again, I'll put the link below. The last one is The Book of Secrets by Deepak Chopra. If you know Deepak Chopra, you know that he's like the king in this, but this book is very much more on the spiritual side of things, which I do kind of gravitate towards. But if you're not spiritual, that's absolutely fine as well, because it kind of helps you to figure out your purpose, and in doing so, helping you think positively about your purpose. This one's really useful. Again, I'll put the link below, so I hope that helps. I know how hard it can be when you're not thinking positively, and it's so important and pivotal in your life to think positively. It transforms every aspect of your life. So I really hope that this helped. If it did, give it a like. You can comment or you can subscribe. I do videos every Tuesday, so I look forward to seeing you next week. Bye.